welcome to the masterclass. This is, my name is Chef Rubia, and I'm a professional chef and the owner of Chad Grill Restaurant and also Chad Grill Company, which owns a range of products. Some of the products I'm going to be using them today in the barbecue masterclass. And for today's menu, I'm going to be doing four things. So the first thing, I'm going to show you how to do like a simple, easy, gourmet style kind of a chicken wings using some, infusing some of the different flavors using the sauce. And the second recipe, I'm going to show you how to do some very nicely done gourmet burgers. And the third and fourth recipe, I'm going to be doing two types of ribs. So I'm going to do your pork ribs and I'm going to do your beef ribs. So without further ado, let's keep on with the process, yeah? So over here, I have some chicken wings. They're already cut into pieces. And for you to have your chicken wings to actually have the best result when you're grilling them on the charcoal grill or using them in the oven now, you need to have a very, very nice, probably a marinade or a wrap. For this case, I'll be using my personal wrap, which is here. It contains all the ingredients that you can actually find a wrap. So I'm going to do this, put the wrap inside, and then add a little bit of some oil. There we go. Then I'm going to mix everything up. And the last piece. So 180 degrees temperature, and then put it in the oven for around 20 to 25 minutes. And then we're ready, the masai. And we're going to be making some gourmet burgers. So for the mince meat, you have your eggs, you have your mince meat, you have your marinade that comprises everything that you can actually use for you to marinate the burger, and you have your one piece of egg. So with this, what you need to do is only mix and get the right consistency for you to actually mold up the burger. Yeah? So here we go. So you need to mix this until it gives that firm texture for you to be able to actually mold the burger. Do the measurements for this, around 150 to 200 grams. But for this, I'll just do them manually. Yeah? So that's finished for this mixture. I'm going to finish it sometime later. So I'll put it aside. And so we have our burgers. And for the burgers, we need a couple of ingredients. Yeah, we need some gherkins. I'm going to have some cheese in there. We also have our burger buns ready over here. And also have my tomatoes and lettuce ready to be lapped up, the base for the burger. So for the burger buns, they are normally good when you actually toss them, give them that crunch, give them that flavor, and when you actually do like a spread of mayo or mustard, it helps in terms of it won't soak in the mayonnaise or the gherkins. So if you want the best pork cuts, or you want the best pork ribs, you want any type of pork cut, the best type of cuts come from a pig that is actually not more than 6 months. So when you have a pig that is not more than 6 months, you get the best cuts in terms of everything. Yeah? And for the beef ribs, actually, the cow should not be more than 2 years. So a cow, 1.5 years, maximum 2 years, gives you the best ribs in terms of quality, in terms of texture, in terms of flavor. But so our pan is already heated. I'm going to toss this. I'm going to probably prepare for my next recipe, which would be the ribs. Yeah, so there we go. So I'll do like for the beef ribs, as you can see here, I changed my gloves as well. They are very, very nicely done in terms of the cuts, as you can see. Very tender, very nice in terms of marbling. There we go. You can see it's brown already. Nicely done. So I'll put this on the side. I'm going to take my beef patties, spread a little bit more, and actually get it cooked over there. This is the second one. We'll do the same thing. So with that, I'm going to be serving all those four ingredients with either sweet potato fries, nicely spiced with paprika and cayenne, and I'm also going or some homemade fries, some nicely done chunky potatoes that you can actually use to have them with your ribs, your burgers, your wings, and the wraps. As you can see, very, 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 very nice color. You can actually see the flex of the hub and each and every marinade. It has salt, it has herbs, it has the garlic, it has the ginger powder, it has all the components that you actually might need for your marinade. Yeah? What you need to do next is actually seal this with foil and put it in your oven. Slow cook it for like 2.5 hours to 3 hours. Huh? So wrap this very airtight with a foil, aluminum foil. Put it in your oven. Cook it for around 130 to 150 degrees Celsius for 2.5 hours to 3 hours. And by then, you're going to have like very nicely done and tender ribs. Huh? So come to my next one, which is the pork rib. As you can see, I'm going to switch off my pair of gloves, throw them in the dustbin, put on some new ones. So same marinade for this. The only thing that probably might change is for the herbs. So for the beef ribs, you can use probably the thyme and probably mix with some rosemary and other herbs. But for the pork, because pork goes on with sage, you can actually use sage as well to get the right flavors and kick when you bring your pork chops. Huh? So for the pork chops, similar thing. You can see very nicely done. I'm going to drizzle up the rub. All the flavors, all the aromas, we're going to get them right. And then, nicely done. There you go. So actually for the pork, yeah, you don't need, as long as you have the rub, that's perfectly fine. You don't need to have like, put hot oil in this. Why? Because the pork has already, it's fatty already. So you just use the rub and you let the pork cook by its own fat. So the same concept and procedure as with the beef ribs. You tie this tightly with the aluminum foil and then you put it in the oven for 2 hours. So I'll start with the pork. As you can see, very nicely done, the rack, very well cooked. So what now I'm going to do is to finish off this. Finishing off this means what? I'm going on to infuse the different flavors I have. For the barbecue sauce, I have four types of flavors. I have the pineapple, I have the passion, I have the spicy mango, and I have the spicy, the chili one. So depending on your preference of flavors and what you like, you can now baste this and put it in the oven or salamander for a few minutes, and it's ready to serve, yeah? So as our burgers are cooking, just do this. And finally, finish this off with the salamander. It's slow heat so that it cooks evenly and completely, yeah? Top. As you can see, that glaze is coming along so fine. I can actually feel the aroma of the pineapple, so do like that. One last shot. So there you go. So once you have this, what you need to do next is have this probably in the oven for like a few 5-7 minutes. For the pork ribs, I want to look at them again. Aha! It's actually done, as you can see. Amazing loss, color, flavor. See? Very, very, very nicely done, yeah? It's, they almost burnt. They're giving you that char grill kind of a thing, yeah? See? Okay, now with this ready, I'm going to actually switch and put the beef on top of the salamander because there's a lot of beef on that side. And it goes also faster. Mm-hmm. And now... Now we have the gherkins and the onions. For the onions, I'm going to do like nicely thin slices. Put them on top, and then the gherkins now. And then have it on top as well. Slice a little bit more of this. And then there we go. So these are the builders for the burger. I'm going to set aside. And now I'm going to do clearance over here so that I can actually do the final presentation. See that blaze? Amazing color. Then I'm going to a little bit punch of the rub, a little bit more of like a paprika and cayenne to give that more kitchen flavor. Here we go. Okay, so our meals are done. The chicken wings are awesome. They're ready in the salamander waiting for us to serve them. Here is our pork ribs. We have our beef ribs actually ready over here, and our burgers as well. So let's get on with the presentation. So for the presentation, I'm going to do like a simple garden salad and the small one we can have over here, and break the dark color of the plates. There we go. And then the last bit. There we go. There we go. And then same goes to the rest. Respective places. You can see the spice actually on them. So I'm going to also put this on the side. And now the main thing is the ribs now, yeah? So I'm going to take this and serve it as a rack, yeah? So I'm going to have this over here. And I'm also going to have like this one right over there. Over here. And then probably this is to have. The sauce is giving that perfect effect, because giving that burning effect. It's like they're almost burnt, but it's called charred. They're charred, not burnt. There we go, and then the last bit. There we go, and then we save it. So last thing I'm going to do is the burger. So I'm going to grab one fill up of the burger. I'm going to do like I'm going to do like a double burger. So yeah, there we go. And I'm going to take up the top and put it on top, yeah, and then hold it, and then there we go. So ladies and gentlemen, those are our meals for the day. So here you have your pork ribs, here you have your wings, and here you have your beef ribs, and then you have your burger, your gourmet burger. So that's it for the day. I hope you enjoyed the masterclass. I hope you learned something new. And your kitchens, and then these are the amazing results that you're going to be getting by the end of it all. So thank you guys for watching. It's been a pleasure. I've been your main chef for the day, Chef Rubia. So till next time, see you.